train travelers. Are you ready for another adventure on the rails again today? It's day three, and we're finding out some great things about how Jesus's power pulls us through life. Now, let's make sure that we are getting started with our train whistle because we need to get all aboard. All aboard for adventure. Let's get our hats on and let's get ready to power shuffle. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. All right, here we go. Trains talk to each other? Isn't that weird? We have an expert, so we're going straight to Kyle. He's going to be our expert on how trains talk to each other. Here's Kyle.
Today's question is, how do trains communicate with each other? Do they communicate with lights, horns, lasers, or sirens? And the answer is horns. Trains communicate through a series of patterns within their horns.
Thank you.
see you back, got back in your seats okay, because we're moving on. We got through Kyle, and he did an awesome job telling us all that information about how trains talk to each other. That's so important that they're able to do that with their whistles. Very cool. Let's dance and sing about God moving us on down the tracks as we're bound for glory.
This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train. In heaven for me, this train is bound for glory. This train.
Okay, now let's bring it down.
This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. This train. This train is bound for glory. Jesus made a place in heaven for me. This train is bound for glory. This train.
Welcome to day three of VBS right here at Leroy United Methodist Church. I'm so glad you're here again today. I know that you're having lots of fun. I ran into a friend that's doing the VBS, and they said that they're having more fun every single day than they did the day before. So that's really good news, and I'm so glad you're enjoying us. I want to call out some of my friends that stopped by and did a God sighting. I love this one. It says, "My God sightings," and they have a caterpillar and a bird and a bunny. I think they have their cats also. And this is from my friend Hannah. So Hannah, thank you so much for stopping by. This is Hannah's sister Vanessa. She drew this beautiful sunshine up there. And I'm not sure she was drawing a picture of maybe her sister or her mom or maybe herself, but Vanessa, thank you so very much. That was really great. We saw some of these that we did yesterday, but there's a new one up here that I want to talk about real quick. This is our Bible verse that we had yesterday. It comes from the book of Psalm, chapter 31, it's verse 24, "Be strong, let your heart take courage, and the rest of it is, and hope in the Lord." That brings us over here to our two words that we've had so far. Day one was trusting God to help us do hard things, and then yesterday, find hope in the Lord. Okay, let's walk over here and see. I found a new one today. Here we have our binoculars from yesterday and our robin in the bird bath and our God loves you. And someone came and wrote that their God sighting was they had fresh produce from their garden. Wow, does that sound perfect? Thank you for all these that have happened. Today, I'm going to kind of give you a little bit of homework. So today, let's think of God sightings as far as our five senses go. So I made I used a few pieces of sidewalk here. So I have God sightings that you would see, God sightings that you would hear, God sightings that you would smell, God sightings that you would taste, and God sightings that you could touch. So boys and girls, and moms and dads, and grandmas and grandpas, and aunts and uncles and cousins, when you come up today to do your God sightings, head over here first and just jot down, or maybe just draw a picture of something that you see or hear or smell or taste or touch. And then if you have something else to do, welcome aboard. All right, see you tomorrow. Bye.
We're so glad that you guys are sending in your God sightings. They are such a blessing to us, and I pray that you just keep that up. We're praying, you know, remember that we're praying for you each day. Each day, we're praying for you and praying that this is teaching you about how much, the most important thing you know, how much God loves you. He loves you so very much. All right, now we were talking, Kyle was talking actually, about how important those train whistles are and how big and bold they are and powerful they are. And sometimes God wants us to be big and bold. And I remember when, one of the very first times that I was ever bold, and I was very shy as a child, extraordinarily shy. And I used to walk home with the kids from school. We'd be walking home, it was about a 10-minute walk from the bus stop. And I always walked with the bigger kids because the elementary had up to sixth graders, and I was probably in first grade or second grade when this happened. But we were walking home and there was a stray dog there, and some of the bigger boys were throwing rocks at the dog. Well, that burned my heart because I know that's not right. It was a dog and he had his tail tucked, and you could tell it was really afraid, and those boys were just tossing rocks at it, making him run. And even though I was so afraid of those bigger kids and I was so shy, I said, "You stop that!" And they did. Sometimes you have to be big and bold about things that are important to you and stand firm for them. And even if the other people don't agree with you, you still need to stand firm. And how do we do that? We do that with Jesus' power. And that's our Bible point for today. So let's stop here in this nice grassy area. Let's get off the train and let's have a little circle here and look at our Bible point for today. Our Bible point today says Jesus' power helps us to be bold. And our Bible verse that goes along with it is from Isaiah chapter 40. Boy, he was a really wordy kind of guy. 40 chapters Isaiah wrote, more than that actually. So he's from the Old Testament, a wonderful prophet. In chapter 40, verse 29, and it says, "He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless." Let's say that together. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. So even if you are young, Jesus can give you the power to do big, bold things. We serve a wonderful and generous God who gives us and is willing to share his power with us, no matter our age, no matter where we're at or what situation we are in. Oh, and I think it's time we get back on the train and get rolling, because according to my schedule, it's time for us to see Pastor Robin. Let's get on. All aboard! Let's see Pastor Robin and our Bible adventure story for today.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Bible Story Time. This week at VBS, we are discovering amazing things about Jesus' power. Today, we are exploring how Jesus' power helps us to be bold. Today's power-packed, totally true story comes from the book of Acts. And to experience what happened, we have traveled to the city of Jerusalem. Now, I'd like for you to imagine for just a minute what it would be like to not be able to walk. Can you imagine having to have somebody carry you everywhere you go? Or being the person who carries someone else who isn't able to walk? Well, our story today is about a man who wasn't able to walk. And it happened right here in this city of Jerusalem. And every day, the man would sit here on this mat. He had never been able to walk. Not one time, not once in the past 40 years had he been able to stand up or even take a step. Now, today in our time, people who can't walk can live a full and productive life. But here in Jerusalem, in Jesus' time, if a person couldn't walk, they couldn't get a job. They couldn't be a carpenter or a fisherman or a potter or a priest. All the man in our story could do was hold out his hands and ask people for money. And sometimes people would toss him a coin or two, but that didn't happen all the time. Most of the time, people would just walk right on by. They wouldn't even look at him. It must have been a really, really hard life. Well, one day, two Christians named Peter and John were on their way to the temple, and they stopped right here in front of the man on the mat. They said they had something for him. And it was even better than he expected. Now Peter, he was bold, and he said something really bold. He said, "I don't have any silver or gold for you, but I will give you what I have. In the name of Jesus, stand up and walk." Now what do you think? How would Peter's gift compare to silver or gold? I don't know, what do you think happened when Peter boldly said that Jesus would heal the man? Well, let me show you what happened. The man stood up and he praised God. Can you do that? Can you stand up and praise God? Well, let me tell you, that miracle caused quite a commotion. A huge crowd gathered all around, and that's when this second incredibly bold thing happened. Peter and John stood up and they started teaching everybody about Jesus. They told the crowd who Jesus was and that Jesus had died for their sins. They told the crowd that they needed Jesus. Well, and that made some of the people in the crowd pretty angry. See, not everyone there in this town of Jerusalem was a fan of Jesus. Some people, including some of Jerusalem's leaders, thought that Jesus was a liar. And they thought that Christians who talked about Jesus were also liars. That makes me wonder or think about something. When is it hard or maybe unpopular for you to talk about Jesus? Is it hard to talk about Jesus at school or with your friends or family? I think you might have experienced that too. You probably have some idea of what it was like for the Christians here in Jerusalem, being afraid or concerned or just being hard to talk about Jesus. Well, the leaders here got so mad at Peter and John that they had guards arrest them and keep them in jail for the night. And the leaders told Peter and John to quit talking about Jesus or else. So how do you feel about being bold now? Wow, yikes. Well, Peter and John had to make a decision. Stay quiet and be safe, or keep talking about Jesus and get in a lot of trouble? Well, Peter and John thought that there were things about Jesus that people should know. They boldly told the leaders, "We can't obey you instead of Jesus. We are not going to stop telling people what we have seen and heard." That's pretty bold, don't you think? They stood up and they took a stand. What about you? What do you think? Can you be bold? Can you strike a superhero pose and be bold? Can you do that? strike a superhero pose, and be bold. Be bold. Jesus' power can help us be bold. Say it with me. Jesus' power can help us be bold. Okay, well, back to Peter and John. Those angry leaders let them go, but they told them not to talk about Jesus anymore. So Peter and John went back to their friends and they told them what had happened. And do you know what their friends did? Their friends prayed. Their friends prayed together, asking for courage. Courage to tell people about Jesus. I know that we all need courage when it comes to being bold in what we believe. And remember, we don't have to face anything alone. Our Bible verse today comes from the book of Isaiah, which is in the Old Testament. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 29, and it says this: He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Isaiah 40, 29. Well, it looks like it's time to head back to Miss Teresa. But before we do that, let's pray. Will you bow your heads and close your eyes and fold your hands with me so that we can pray? Dear Jesus, thank you for always being with us. It's comforting to know that we are never alone. When we feel like we are the only ones who believe in you, or we are the only ones who face hard stuff, we know that you are right beside us, giving us strength and boldness. We love you and thank you. In your name, amen. So remember, Jesus' power helps us be bold. Strike your superhero pose. Be bold. Be bold. Jesus' power helps us be bold. Have a great day. Bye.
All right, welcome back. We're rolling back down the tracks again, and let's make those tracks move along a little bit faster with a song. Let's go with our theme song.
Trust in you, Jesus, you're all, you're all, you're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in you, we're trusting in you. You give us hope and life that's forever. You make us bold and we stand together. This journey, there's no looking back. With Jesus to lead us, we're on the right track. Oh, 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 oh. Wide open spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, 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 oh. We trust, we trust, we trust in you, Jesus, you're all. Spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, 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 oh.
story of boldness today during your Bible adventure story. It's amazing how small things like words seem, but how very powerful and how bold they can be. Even if it makes you seem like you're weak, if you have Jesus's power, you can be as bold as can be and as powerful as can be. There is definitely power in the tongue. Power in the tongue. Oh, and here comes one of our bold friends that you might remember. It's Allie. Come on, Allie.
Hey guys, it's Allie from Crafts from the Basement. Hope you guys are enjoying VBS and choose Jesus.
Oh, goodness. It is so good to see her, isn't it? Now, I have one of your favorite songs, and do you remember my daughter, Marielle? Marielle and I are doing this song for you. So here you go. Make sure that you get on your feet right now, because you'll be wanting to do this with us. It's one of your favorite songs. All right, here's Marielle and I. Come on.
All right. Here's the oldie but a goodie I was talking about. And remember who this is? You remember it's Marielle? We're going to sing that song for you, so make sure you're on your feet. Here we go. Ready, set. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. All right, a little bit faster this time. Here we go. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Okay, now this is going to be the fastest that we can probably go, Marielle. Here we go. Ready, set, go. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Woohoo! Good job.
We're getting ready to roll into our home station. Here we go. Yep, and I want you to remember that you need to look at your art project and your snack and your game for today in your bag. That's really important so that you can get all of the fun done today. And don't forget to give us your God sightings. Also, don't forget about our mission project. I think that we have a mission update from Miss Jackie today. So here she is with an update on that.
Hi, VBS families. Welcome back to Rocky Railway Mission Project. Wanted to give you a little update today. We have a total of 122 pairs of new children's socks in our donation box so far. That's fantastic. You're doing a great job. I'll be looking in our box later in the week again and give you another update. So you can bring your donations over of brand new children's socks to the church porch on the side beside the office. We have this box out. You can come anytime this week and put your socks in our donation box. And again, VBS families, right now we have 122 pairs. Great job. You have a good week. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Awesome job on the mission project. That's great. Now remember, again, how much we love you, and we're looking forward to seeing you again tomorrow. Here's Pastor Robin to pray us out.
Hey, everybody. I hope you're having a great time at our VBS so far. Do you remember from Bible story today, if you could do your superhero pose, be bold. Can you do that? Everybody do it. Be bold. All right. Remember, Jesus' power helps us be bold. And we are going to pray now for all of us to be bold in telling people about Jesus. So let's pray. Dear God, we thank you that you give us power to be bold. Help us to tell others about you and how much you love us. We thank you for each of the kids who's part of Vacation Bible School this week, and help them to always remember that your power is with them, and that you are always with them, and that you love them. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, So have a great day, everybody. Remember, Jesus' power helps us be bold. Bye.
We trust in you, Jesus. You're all that we need.